What part of the country are we in?
Willisburg.
Compliments to the Willisburg Church and for all that they've done here. It's not at completion yet, but we can see someday, soon it will be. It's truly, truly an honor to see what has been done right here. It truly is. And compliments to our general staff that is here, to every pastor and to every member of our region. It's good to have all this general staff with us from headquarters, and it's so good to have you folks and even the state overseer from Tennessee. I can remember when I used to think that it would be such a thrill to get to speak at convention, any convention, especially state convention. I can remember when I thought it would be such a thrill to speak to an overseer. But after I got to the first time and after several times, I don't know about that now. I truly and I truly would prefer someone else, but it is an honor to be here today. Health and strength. It's an honor to have our grandchildren with us today. If you see something good about them, I think that's part of me shining out. If you see something bad or just plain terrible, I hope, and I'm not sure, but I think maybe that's the side of the family that we don't know that well, is what I think that it might be. But it is good to have them with us today. We did gain one that's not been with us. This is his first trip with us out of town, I believe. It would be correct to say, especially in a church convention or anything. But it's an honor to be here today. And it's the topic is, how can two walk together unless they agree? And be very difficult. I'm not going to say that it's impossible to walk with someone that does not agree with you, but my friend, it can become very difficult.
Yes.
It can become hard. Yes, it can become very challenging. It truly can. And it's almost impossible to achieve anything or to be successful if someone does not agree with you.
Yes.
I believe at work I have 70-some people now to look after they added another section just a few weeks ago. And I find all kinds of people that's very difficult to deal with. They don't agree with hardly anything at all. But even in the church, it is very, very difficult to work with someone that does not agree with you.
Bless
that does not have the same thoughts that you have. That does not have the same thing in mind that you have. But all church, we as a church must agree today. Our walk must be the same walk today.
Yes.
Our talk must be the same talk today.
Yes.
Our look must be the same look today. Our goals must be the same goals today. And our accomplishments must be the same accomplishments. And our ideals must come from the same one. Oh my, and that would be no one except the Master that be above. In Amos chapter 3 and verse 3, it said, can two walk together except they be agreed?
Yeah.
It is very difficult, even in a home, for even a husband or a wife to accomplish very, very much unless they agree on how they correct the children, or where the children are going to attend a school, and on things that even happen in a home. But in a church, in order to accomplish what we must accomplish, we must look to Him.
Yes.
And our mind must be Christ-like.
Amen.
And He is His mind. He must be the one that controls our mind. He must be the one that controls our attitude.
Yes.
If we're going to accomplish what God has called us to accomplish.
Yes.
If we are going to achieve the goal that God has for us to achieve, we can only do it through Him.
Cannot
do it if we are not if we do not agree.
Amen.
In Psalms, if you'd like to turn with me to the book of Psalms, 133, I believe it is, in verse 12. Psalms 133 and verse 12. this doesn't have a verse 12, I'm sorry, can you read my own writing, verses 1 and 2? I believe that it is. Now you just bear with me a little bit and be much in prayer for me, that I can share a thought with you this evening, that God would be blessed by what we say and that you would be blessed, because it is so important today, it truly is, that we hear from heaven this next few
moments.
He said, behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious ointment upon the head that run down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard, that went down to his skirts of his garments. Happiness is found in true fellowship with Christian people, and especially with the church. It's good for God's people to have fellowship and to have unity together. Church, it truly is. If we're going to accomplish what God would have us to accomplish, we must have unity and must have the same faith and must have the same doctrine. And the doctrine must come from what thus saith the Word of God. Church, walking together, talking together, working together, and being together is a must today. I say again that we must think the same, we must talk the same, we must preach the same, we must teach the same. If we're going to be the church of the living Bible, we truly must be today. God's way is different than any other way. The brother before us earlier today mentioned that God's thoughts are not our thoughts. God's ways are not our ways. His thoughts are so much higher than our thoughts, and His way is so much greater than our ways. But my friend, if we have the mind of Christ and are willing to be led by Him and are willing to walk with Him, to talk with Him, and to live with Him, we can accomplish a great accomplishment that God has set for us to accomplish. We have a great big commission. It was mentioned earlier that we are to go into all the world and to preach to every creature, my friend. That means everywhere we are to go. In order to do that, we must have the unity that comes from nowhere except from above.
Praise the Lord.
That we be unified together. Even we used to hear a nation that stands together cannot be broken down, cannot be destroyed. My friend, when we bind together, He will seal us with His own seal, and He will take care of us the way that we need to be taken care of.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
But oh, I like what it said. Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. Have you ever tried to work with someone that was just unbearable? Have you ever tried to be somewhere where someone was just so in disagreement with you? You didn't get very much done at all, did you? I was raised where there was 8 of us siblings at that home, and I can remember being sent with some of the others to do work in the field, and it was so hard when they complained and groaned and didn't want to do their part. It put a heavier load on us that was willing to work and willing to do our part. But when everybody pulled together, we accomplished so much more, and the work was so much more pleasant. It truly was. I'm not saying that we're not together today, because I believe that we are together today. Find us with cords that cannot be broken. Lord, find us with a faith cord that is stronger than anything, Lord. Bind us and root us and ground us, Lord, into Your Word, Lord, that we can understand what no one else is understand. Oh, my church, it is important to be together today. It is important to speak the same thing today. I can remember back.